I used to want to go out and research what I was writing about. Everybody that was connected with me at that time thought this was a horrible thing for me to do. Of course, you must realize that when I did this sort of thing, I would turn up 3, 4, 6 weeks later with nothing left of my wardrobe but a pair of gum boots and some old corduroy pants, you know. Stubble of beard. I'd gone out and lived the part, you know. I'd be in a remarkably secondhand condition, broken fingernails and all that sort of thing. If you're going to write a story about logging, well, you better get in and log, man. You better get in and log. Yeah, you go down and sign up on the logging crew. You know, and you decide you know all about being a sawyer now. You better be a feller, something of that sort. So you tell some tall tales. You have to be awfully slippery, you know, to be able to do this, because it means you've got to acquire professional skill while walking up to the manager and then exhibit it after being hired. Makes for a quick study. They didn't like to see me do this. I'd just disappear out of Ken. Of course, they'd worry about me and all that sort of thing. I'd come back with engine oil all over me, having been a stunt pilot for 7 weeks, you know. Write a story about it. It worried them, as one could see, but it was a dirty trick. I used to have a system of not writing about things I didn't know about. Now, I think it's a fairly good maxim. I would advise it to almost anybody.